This video is going to be about adding and subtracting polynomials. And this is really a pretty easy process. As long as you're careful and watch for little mistakes, you should be fine. So here we go. Let's do some with adding first. Okay, so we've got two polynomials. The first one is 4x squared minus 3x plus 2. And we want to add 5x squared plus 2x minus 7. Now, if you take a second and look at this whole thing, you realize that the parentheses aren't really adding anything to the problem. All they're doing is showing us that we have two polynomials instead of one big one. So what that means is we can disregard these parentheses and start doing the adding. So what we're going to do is called combining like terms. Like terms are terms where the variables are the same, in other words, the x's in this case, and the exponents are the same, although the coefficients might be different. So looking at 4x squared and 5x squared, we realize that even though the coefficients are different, both of them have an x and is x, basically it's x squared. So we can add these two together. We're just going to add 4 and 5. What we're counting is the number of x squareds. So 4x squareds and 5x squareds is going to give us 9x squared. Moving on to the x's, we've got a negative 3x and a positive 2x. Once again, we're just counting x's. So we've got negative 3 of them and positive 2. That means we've got negative 1. We can just write that as negative x. And then we're combining positive 2 and negative 7. We're 2 minus 7. That's just going to be negative 5. And that's the whole process. When you write these, just like with the original polynomials, usually you're going to have your exponents in descending order. In other words, you'll start with the highest exponent, the 2, and then a 1, and then just the constant number, if there is one. Here's another addition problem. So we've got 5x cubed plus 7x squared minus x, and we're adding 8x cubed plus 4x minus 5. So let's start with our highest exponent, which is the 3. So we've got 5x cubed plus 8x cubed. That means we have 13 altogether. So I've got 13x cubed. Then I'll go to my next exponent down would be 2, so I'm looking for x squared. I've got a 7x squared, and over in the second polynomial, there is no x squared at all. So I'm just going to have 7x squared. Then I've got a negative x and a positive 4x, so that's like negative 1 and positive 4. Negative 1 and positive 4 is positive 3. So this is going to be 3x. And I've got no constant in here, but I've got a negative 5 in the second polynomial. So since there's nothing to add that to, I'll just leave it like it is. So here's my answer. 13x to the third, or 13x cubed, plus 7x squared, plus 3x minus 5. Once again, notice that my exponents are in descending order. 3, 2, I could write a little 1 here if I wanted to, but it's not necessary. Okay, so let's go on to subtraction. Subtraction is not much more difficult. Let me fix this. Subtraction is not much more difficult after we've taken care of the minus sign. So here are two polynomials, 8x squared plus 2x minus 10x squared plus 2x minus 9. Now, when we have this negative sign here, that's the same, if you want to, you can think of that as being negative 1 times this thing. So in other words, we can distribute a negative 1 across this polynomial. So rewriting the whole thing, we're going to have 8x squared plus 2x. And then I'm going to distribute this negative 1 to these three numbers, these three terms. So I'm going to have negative 10x squared. Negative 1 times 2x will be negative 2x. And then negative 1 times negative 9, well, negative times negative is positive, so that's positive 9. Now I've gotten rid of my parentheses, so I can just look for like terms and combine them. So starting with the highest level exponent, my 2, my x squared, I've got 8x squared and a negative 10x squared. So 8 and negative 10 is going to be negative 2x squared. My next exponent is just going to be the x's, x to the first power. So I've got a positive 2x and a negative 2x. Well, positive 2 minus 2 is 0, so there's nothing to say there. They cancel each other out. And now going down to my constant, I've only got one constant, which is the 9. So this thing simplifies down pretty nicely to negative 2x squared plus 9. One more. Okay, so here I'm starting with a subtraction. I'm starting with a negative times the polynomial, 6x to the third minus 4x, minus the polynomial, 2x to the third plus 2x, I'm sorry, 2x to the third plus x squared minus 2x. So let's take care of the negative signs first. Once again, just as a reminder, I'm going to tell myself that this is negative 1 times this whole thing, and negative 1 over here times the whole thing, times the polynomial. And now I'll just distribute this negative 1. So that's going to give me negative 6x to the third. And I've got negative 1 times negative 4x. So that's going to be a positive 4x. Distributing this negative 1, I've got negative 1 times 2x to the third. So that's going to be negative 2x to the third. Negative 1 times x squared is just negative x squared. And negative 1 times negative 2x is going to give me a positive 2x. Okay, I've gotten rid of my parentheses, so now I can look for like terms and combine them. Starting with the highest degree, I've got x to the third. So I've got a negative 6x to the third and a negative 2x to the third. So that's negative 6 and negative 2. Negative 6 plus negative 2 is negative 8 x to the third. I've got no squares over here, but here's a square. So that's the only squared x that I've got. So that's just going to be negative x squared. Going down to my x's, I've got a 4x and a 2x. Well, those are combined to 6. So that's plus 6x. And that's going to be my answer. Okay, so like I said, there's really nothing very hard about this. The main thing is to look out for small mistakes like forgetting to distribute your negatives, or maybe adding improperly, or missing some of the terms that you have to add together. If you're careful about this, you should have no trouble at all. Okay, so take care. See you next time.